Hey everybody, I'm here today to show you how to drain the water in a washing machine. This will be a simple tutorial and I will be going over the basic steps for draining any remaining water in the washing machine. Let's get right into the video. The first step, and obviously as you can see there's no water in this washing machine, but this is what I would do and have done when I've been in this situation because it happens from time to time. The first step is going to be to unload the clothes. So you want to take all the clothes and you want to unload them from the washing machine. Now they're obviously still going to be wet, so hopefully you wring them out inside of a sink or somewhere where there's a drain so that you're not like dragging soaking wet clothes all over the house to where you're going to be placing them to dry. But essentially you want to remove the clothes and then you're going to see that there's going to be water in here. Okay, now sometimes washing machines malfunction, especially newer washing machines. For some reason they seem to malfunction with this one specific thing where they forget to drain the water, and this happens every once in a while, and it's happened to me a handful of times with this machine in the last, I don't know, 5 to 6 years. But essentially, when it does not drain, you want to remove the clothes and then you want to look for the cycle on the machine that says drain on it. Okay, so they even have a built-in cycle that is specifically just for draining the water and spinning whatever water is left in the clothes. Okay, so you want to run this cycle or any cycle that says drain on it. So it's going to say drain and spin. If you can even run, if it doesn't have a drain option, you can even run like a rinse and spin, which is like a non-soap cycle, right? So if you want to, you want to run the shortest possible cycle, look for one that says drain on it. And if not, you want to run the one that doesn't have any soap on it, which would be like rinse and spin. So you want to run that cycle and hopefully it drains. Now here's the thing, if it doesn't drain at that point, let's say you run the drain and spin and it just ends up spinning and trying to drain but nothing happens, the water's still in there, then you might have a problem with your pump. Okay, and if that's the case, you're gonna have to get this water out of here manually. So what I would recommend is you get some buckets, take the buckets and unload the majority of the water until you can't scoop up any more with the buckets. Okay, you're gonna just dump it into a sink. Then you're gonna get like a rag or a towel, and you're gonna use that rag or towel to get all of the water at the bottom and unload that water. Now here's the thing, there's still gonna be water inside of the washing machine. There's still gonna be water inside of it. Just because you remove all the water from here doesn't mean there's none down there. There's still gonna be water inside of it and inside of the hose and stuff. But if your pump is not working, at least you don't have any water in here. And then you can get your pump fixed. But at least the machine is lighter for when you want to move it, and it's easier to operate, and you're not worrying about standing water in this basin for an extended period of time. Okay, so essentially what you want to do if you want to drain the water from a washing machine is the following. First and foremost, remove the clothes. You don't have to, but I recommend doing it because it's just easier to work with and easier to try and figure out what the problem is. Secondly, you want to look for the option, the shortest cycle, and you're looking for the word drain on there. So you want to find a cycle that has a drain in it, and if there's nothing that has drain in it, you're going to want to find the one that has like the shortest cycle without any soap. So rinse and spin would be no soap. Drain and spin would be not adding any additional water. So you want to find out what's going on. Now, one thing is, if there's a problem with the pump inside the washing machine and this is already like full of water and you use like a rinse and spin where it's going to add more water, you do run the risk of extra water and it overflowing. So you have to be careful. Be mindful of how much water is in there. If you want to try it out to be safe, if you only have a rinse and spin and not a drain and spin, then you can like empty out all the water and then try and do that option. It's up to you. And if that doesn't work, if the water's still in there, then that means that there's likely a problem with the pump or the drainage system, and that is something that you're gonna have to look into further. If you want me to do a specific video on how to replace the pump and the various components of a washing machine, drop a comment below and I'll do my best. If I see a lot of comments requesting it, I'll do my best to make it happen. And that's basically it. I really hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you liked it, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.